getting engaged left and right. Contact right, contact right. Back of our vehicle just got hit. 20 Trillion Marines up there that got hit. It's pretty catastrophic.
My name is Chris Merkel. I'm a veteran in the United States Marine Corps, and I'm a full-time student trying to reinvent myself and transition back into a normal civilian life. I joined right out of high school when I was 17. My role in the Marine Corps was just a grunt infantryman, so nothing fancy, just the down and dirty of what war comes down to. You've experienced something that's horrific that your body doesn't know how to comprehend. And when you don't address it, it just manifests in this horrible thing, and you end up locked in your room, hating the world, thinking everybody's coming after you. And I didn't want to be that person. Talk therapy after talk therapy, it wasn't working. And I was like, now what? What am I going to do? Virtuality was a godsend.
Okay. You can begin to narrate the experience that you went through.
All right, so it's really dark. It's early morning. All right, there you go. We start taking some small arms fire, some machine gun fire. Can you do a big explosion up ahead? Yeah, just a really surreal scene just to see event after event after event after event.
I think it's hard for people to imagine the enormity of the challenges that people face when they come back from war and adjust to civilian life. We can activate emotions in a very deep way in VR, helping a patient go back and confront and process very difficult emotional memories. Advanced processing power, faster computers are essential for delivering good VR. With the technology getting better, computers have gotten faster, and you know, things like some of the latest Intel processors, they're mind-blowing. They're like rockets. And so that's why we can deliver VR that can make a difference in people's lives. You know, we ask so much of our service members, and we can't forget them when they come back. They deserve our best efforts and the best technology available to help them get back on the right track for the rest of their life.
So I'm setting a new path for myself. I want to be a clinical psychologist. I finished my undergrad literally 2 weeks ago. I jumped ahead to a master's and a doctorate program yesterday. I have 5 years ahead of me and then a whole lifetime ahead of that to hopefully help as many people as I can and go to school and help others.
VR is a transformative technology that's going to change everything about how we learn, how we heal, how we experience places that we could never go to. The cool thing is that these are really consumer products. Everyone will have one in their home, and the advanced level of processing that we're getting allows everyone to be able to buy a computer that'll run a state-of-the-art VR headset, and you'll be able to consume media in dramatically new ways. There's so much value beyond just entertainment. To use the power of this technology to help people, that is really exciting for me.